Hello students, the next important topic from the posterior abdominal wall which I'm going to take is the inferior vena cava. You all know the superior vena cava which I have taught you in the thorax part when I did in the lectures in the class. Inferior vena cava is one of the largest vein of the body, and this vein, it drains the deoxygenated blood from the structures in the abdomen and in the lower limb. This is one of the largest vein in the body, as you all know. So it brings the deoxygenated blood from lower part of the body, that is below the diaphragm. So this is by inferior vena cava. This knowledge you all have. Now, what is the location of the inferior vena cava? If you go for the location of the inferior vena cava, where it is located? This inferior vena cava, it lies on the posterior abdominal wall to the right of the abdominal aorta. Okay, it is to the right of the abdominal aorta. That means if you are standing in the anatomical position, okay, you're standing in the anatomical position, so inferior vena cava would be on the right side of the abdominal aorta. Okay, you have done ascending aorta, arch of aorta, then descending aorta. Descending aorta is more towards the left side. So this is on the right side of the abdominal aorta. What is the formation of IVC? What is, how it is formed? Which are the veins which helps in formation of the IVC? It is formed by the union of the right and left common iliac veins. So the formation is by the union of the right and left common iliac veins. And this common iliac veins are formed by the union of the internal and external veins. Now, if you see one diagram here, which we have shown, okay, this is the diagram. This big vein is the inferior vena cava. Okay. So this is an inferior vena cava, and this vein will bring deoxygenated blood to the above, to the right atrium. You all know this, okay? So this is right to the abdominal aorta. So abdominal aorta would be left to it, okay? So this is so abdominal aorta would be somewhere here, and this is right to the abdominal aorta, and it will bring deoxygenated blood to the right atrium. Okay, now this is your inferior vena cava. Now the inferior vena cava is formed by joining right and left common iliac veins. They join to form inferior vena cava. Now the right and the left, so if we take, this is the right common iliac vein, this is the left common iliac vein, this is the right common iliac vein, the left common iliac vein. They unite and they form IVC, inferior vena cava. Now this right and left common iliac veins are altogether formed by the union of internal and external iliac veins, and they join to form common iliac vein. Now the internal iliac vein and the external iliac vein. The internal iliac vein and the external iliac vein. So the internal iliac vein and the external iliac vein of the left side, and the internal iliac vein and the external iliac vein of the right side, they unite to form left and right common iliac veins. Clear? So this way the IVC is formed. Again I'll repeat, the internal and external iliac vein of the left side and the internal and external iliac vein of the right side, they unite to form right and left common iliac veins, and this right and left common iliac veins, they unite to form inferior vena cava. Okay, so this is the formation of IVC. Now, this veins run along the corresponding arteries. So it is internal and external iliac arteries. They are running along with the veins. Each external iliac vein begins behind the inguinal ligament as the continuation of the femoral vein. The femoral vein drains the lower limb and lies alongside the femoral artery. So external iliac vein, it begins behind the inguinal ligament as the continuation of the femoral vein. So now you can see here, this is the inguinal ligament, this is the femoral vein. So femoral vein, which drains the lower limb, and it becomes continuous with the external iliac vein behind the inguinal ligament. Okay, now the femoral vein drains the lower limb and lies alongside the femoral artery. So femoral vein, it drains the lower limb and it lies along the femoral artery. So whatever vein is there alongside the arteries is also running. So this way IVC is formed. Again, I will repeat how the IVC is formed. This could be an important MCQ question or your important Viva question. Now, you can see if I go from below, this is your inguinal ligament, and you must have studied in the lower limb about the femoral vein. So femoral vein, it crosses the inguinal ligament and it continues as external iliac vein. The external iliac vein together with the internal iliac vein of both the sides, they form right and left common iliac veins. And this right and left common iliac veins unite together to form IVC. So femoral vein continues as external iliac vein. External iliac vein plus the internal iliac vein, they join to form common iliac vein, and common iliac vein of both the sides join to form IVC. And femoral vein drains deoxygenated blood from the lower limb. Clear? So this is the formation of IVC. The next thing we'll study is where IVC terminates. It pierces the diaphragm to open into the right atrium. You all know IVC, it ends in the right atrium of the heart, right side of the heart, that is right chamber of the heart. Okay, so it ends in the right atrium. The length of the IVC is 20 to 25 centimeter long. The length of IVC is 20 to 25 centimeter long. So please remember this. What is IVC? What is its location? How it's formed? Where it ends? And what is its length? Now we'll see what are the relations of IVC. Whenever the IVC is running through and through, which are the structures which are related to inferior vena cava? Now, there is one very simple table here given. There are anterior relations of IVC and there are posterior relations of IVC. Now, there is anterior relations of IVC. You can see here there is a scheme to show the anterior relations of the IVC. What are the structures which are anteriorly related to IVC? Okay. Now, you can see this is your IVC, inferior vena cava. Okay, this is your inferior vena cava. Okay, now we'll see what are the structures which are related anteriorly to the IVC. Okay, the first would be the liver. Okay, which is not shown in this diagram, but obviously on the right side, the IVC is on the right side because it enters into the right atrium. So anterior relation would be the liver. Okay, liver is present anteriorly. Okay, next is the epiploic foramen. The epiploic foramen is the foramen which is present between the lesser omentum and the greater omentum. This omentum is a part of peritoneum. Okay, and it covers the stomach. So there is one foramen between the omentum that is known as epiploic foramen. So that foramen or sac-like structure, it forms the anterior relation of IVC, which is present anteriorly. So it is present on the anterior. So this is your IVC, so it will be present anteriorly, which is anterior to the, this is IVC, so anterior, upar, aage ki side. So that is anterior relations of the IVC. Next is the superior part of duodenum. So the superior part of duodenum, this part, the first part of duodenum, superior part of duodenum is one of the relation. then the head of the pancreas. Okay, the head of the pancreas. The head of the pancreas is present inside the C-shaped duodenum. This part is related to the head of the pancreas. This is not drawn. See this, they have not drawn. You can see, but this part is related to the head of the pancreas. So superior part of the duodenum and the head of the pancreas is the anterior relation of the IVC. Okay, it forms the anterior relation. The next is the horizontal part of the duodenum. You can see the first part, the superior part and the horizontal part of the duodenum. So this is the superior part of the duodenum and the horizontal part of the duodenum is the anterior relation of the IVC. The next is the root of the mesentery containing the superior mesenteric artery and vein. So superior mesenteric artery and superior mesenteric vein. Okay, so you can see here the lower part of the IVC is crossed by the testicular or ovarian artery and by the superior mesenteric vessels which lie in the root of the mesentery. So this is the mesenteric vessels, superior mesenteric artery, okay, and superior mesenteric veins. Okay, so this part, the anterior relation of the IVC in the lower part. Okay, other structures are the portal vein. Okay, it forms the anterior relation. Okay, the bile duct, the hepatic artery. Okay, the celiac trunk. Okay, so this forms the anterior relation and also the testicular arteries. You can see here the testicular and the ovarian arteries and veins, they form the relation. Okay, so these are the anterior relation of the IVC, the structures which are present anterior. Again I'll repeat, if we go one by one. Okay, from above you'll see one part is the liver. It's a part of inner cavity is covered by the liver and may be embedded in it. So it is not drawn here, but the part of the IVC is covered by the liver and may be embedded in it. So this part, upper part of the IVC is related to liver. This is liver. Then in the liver you have bile duct, hepatic duct, portal vein and celiac trunk. Then the anterior relation is superior part of duodenum. Okay, the head of the pancreas, which is not drawn here. Okay, the horizontal part of duodenum. This is all anterior relation. Then it is crossed by testicular artery in males or the ovarian arteries in females. Also superior mesenteric artery and superior mesenteric veins. Okay, and also just above its lower end the artery is crossed by the right common iliac artery. Okay, so these are the anterior relation of the IVC. Now we'll go to the posterior relations of the IVC. What are the structures which are present on the posterior aspect of the IVC? Okay, so this is the left common iliac artery and vein. Okay, this is the artery, this is the vein. This is the lower end of the IVC, what you have drawn here. So what are the posterior relations of the IVC? So this is IVC. Okay, this is your IVC. So they have just drawn the outline of the IVC. So you have to imagine the posteriorly. What are the posterior relations of the IVC? The upper part of the vein, it rests on the right crest of the diaphragm. So posteriorly would be the right crest of the diaphragm. In the upper part of IVC is posteriorly related to the right crest of diaphragm. The lower part is 3rd, 4th and 5th lumbar vertebrae. So lumbar vertebrae L3, L4 and L5 in the lower part. So upper part, it is related to the right crest of the diaphragm. This is IVC, right crest of the diaphragm. And in the lower part, it is related to 3rd, 4th and 5th lumbar vertebrae posteriorly. Okay, lumbar vertebrae posteriorly. Okay, obviously it would be lumbar vertebrae in the lower part. Posteriorly would be L3, 4th and 5th lumbar vertebrae. Now, diaphragm is separated from the vessel by part of the right suprarenal gland and by the right celiac ganglion. So, the posterior relation again is the right suprarenal gland, okay, which is above the kidneys and also the right celiac ganglion, okay, that forms the posterior relation. Okay, the medial margin of the right psoas major muscle. Psoas major muscle, I have already explained in posterior abdominal muscle video. Okay, so psoas major muscle is from the posterior relation. Next is right sympathetic trunk descends behind the vena cava. So there is sympathetic trunk. You know, there is sympathetic trunk surrounding the thoracic and lumbar vertebrae. So this sympathetic trunk, okay, it forms the posterior relation of the IVC. Okay. So arteries which are arising from the aorta, that is abdominal aorta. This is your abdominal aorta. So the arteries, so you have seen the, it is abdominal aorta and IVC is right to the abdominal aorta. It is lying right to the abdominal aorta. So the arteries which are arising from the abdominal aorta, that is the right renal artery, okay. Then right inferior phrenic artery arising from the abdominal aorta, okay. Right suprarenal artery arising from the abdominal aorta. And third and fourth right lumbar arteries. Third and fourth lumbar arteries on the right side. These are forming the posterior relation of the IVC. So, the posterior relation again, in the upper part is the right crest of the diaphragm. And in the lower part, okay, in the lower part would be your third, fourth and fifth lumbar vertebrae. L5, L4, L3 lumbar vertebrae, okay. Next, you can see from above is the right suprarenal gland, the right celiac ganglion, okay. Then the sympathetic trunk, okay. Then the psoas major muscle. Clear? The lumbar arteries, okay. Which are the lumbar arteries which are present? They are the L3 to L5. Lies on the medial margin of the right psoas. So the lumbar arteries are also arising. Okay, that is third and fourth right lumbar arteries arising from the abdominal aorta. So the arteries arising from abdominal aorta is the right inferior phrenic artery, right suprarenal artery, then right renal artery, okay, and the lumbar arteries. Left common iliac artery also. So this forms the posterior relation of the abdominal IVC. Okay, so this was the anterior and posterior relations of the IVC. The next thing we'll take are the tributaries of the IVC. You all know if you are studying any vein, it will have its own tributaries. So we'll take the tributaries of the IVC. Now, in the tributaries of the IVC, there are direct tributaries of the IVC, okay? There are direct tributaries, which means it drains directly into the IVC. So, we take the tributaries of the IVC, okay? Here we take the tributaries of the IVC, okay? So, the tributaries would be anterior, and the tributaries would be lateral. So the tributaries would be, say, hepatic veins. This is anterior. We take hepatic veins. So these are right hepatic vein. We'll take. So this is hepatic veins, which forms the tributary. Okay. So this hepatic vein joins the IVC and gets drained into the right atrium. The middle hepatic vein and the left hepatic vein. So these are the hepatic veins which drains into the IVC on the anterior aspect. So these are the hepatic veins, right, left and the middle hepatic veins. Okay, these are the veins which drains into the IVC. Now lateral veins. Lateral means arising laterally from the IVC. So the lateral veins are, we'll take the right that is we'll take the lateral veins, that is the renal veins. So this is right renal vein, the left renal vein. These are the lateral veins, the right renal vein, the left renal vein, okay, and the right suprarenal vein. So it is not shown in the diagram here, but there is right suprarenal vein, okay. Next is the lateral abdominal veins. So the lateral abdominal veins, okay, those veins are the inferior phrenic vein. So these are the lateral abdominal inferior phrenic vein, and see, inferior phrenic vein, okay, these are the lateral abdominal veins. Four lumbar veins, first and second open into the lumbar zygos, and third and fourth open directly into the IVC. Okay, so there are four lumbar veins which are present in the one of the tributaries of IVC. Okay, the four lumbar veins, the first and second, see this, you can see these are the four lumbar veins, 1, 2, 3, 4. Here it is not shown the fourth, but why it is not shown? Because the first and second open into the lumbar zygous vein. Okay, so this is the diagram. The first and these are four lumbar veins, you can see first, second, three, four. So the first and second lumbar veins, okay, it drains into the lumbar zygous vein. Okay, so it drains into the lumbar zygous vein, first, second, it drains into the lumbar zygous vein. Okay, and the third and fourth open directly into the IVC. So the third and fourth lumbar veins, it directly opens to the IVC, but the first and second, it first drains into the lumbar zygous vein and then it opens into the IVC. Okay, so these are the tributaries of the IVC. The next is the two common iliac veins. Okay, these are the tributaries and also helps in formation of the IVC, and also the median sacral veins. The median sacral veins, it is also the tributaries. Okay, one of the tributaries of IVC. Okay, the median sacral veins from the sacrum. Okay, so it is not shown in the diagram, but the median sacral veins, they are forming the tributaries. Okay, so again we will repeat the tributaries. Now these are certain tributaries which directly open into the IVC. So tributaries of the IVC, direct tributaries of the IVC are, the largest tributaries of IVC are the hepatic veins from the liver and the renal veins from the kidneys. So we'll study the hepatic veins are terminal parts of an elaborate venous tree that permeates the liver. Now direct tributaries means these are the veins which directly join the IVC. So first is the hepatic veins. The hepatic veins emerge from the liver tissue, okay, in close contact with vena cava, and immediately enters the vena cava. So these are the hepatic veins which directly enters into IVC. This is IVC, so it directly enters into the IVC. Hepatic veins means coming from the liver. So right, left, and middle hepatic veins. This is our other one tributaries. Next tributary is the renal vein. The right or left, it runs horizontal from the hilum of the corresponding kidney to join the IVC. Okay. Now it arises. You can see here the renal right kidney, the left kidney. This is right renal vein and this is the left renal vein. Okay, now you can see the left renal vein is much longer as compared to the right renal vein. These are direct tributaries of IVC, means they are directly opening into the IVC. Okay, so the right vein is about 2.5 centimeter, lies behind the descending part of the duodenum, and the left is much longer. So right is 2.5 centimeter only and the left is 7.5 centimeter. Okay, now then the right, as it crosses the midline to reach the vena cava, it crosses anterior to the aorta and posterior to the body of pancreas and the splenic vein. is homologous to a segment of anterior termination of renal veins. Some veins of the right side open into the inferior vena cava, but the corresponding veins of the left side end in the left renal vein. Now, the next tributaries is the right renal vein and the left renal vein. The right renal vein is shorter, 2.5 cm, and the left renal vein is longer, it is 7.5 cm, because it has to cross the midline and reach the IVC. It has to cross the midline. This is the midline. So it has to cross the midline, it has to reach the IVC. Left kidney is on the left side, but IVC is on the right side. So it has to cross from left to right. So it is longer. Okay. Now, some veins, okay, they directly drain into the IVC, but some veins on the left side, okay, some veins on the left side, they first drain into the left renal vein and then into the IVC. Okay, they first drain into the left renal vein and then into the IVC. Okay, so which are these veins? I'll proceed further in my next video of inferior vena cava. Thank you.